getting to where you're at meant getting that shot at the world championship. Vic Darchinyan,
right.
Undefeated when you fought him. He was knocking out people left and right. And he had absolutely no respect for you and your family.
Exactly.
He beat your brother, Glenn Donaire. That was ruled a tactical decision because Glenn injured his shoulder, was it?
No, his jaw.
His jaw?
It was an elbow that came in the second or third round.
And so we couldn't continue?
He couldn't continue after
but
that.
But Darchinyan had absolutely no respect for your family.
Nah,
you wanted to beat him badly.
Exactly.
That was July of 2007. Tell us what happened, that world championship shot.
It was just an incredible moment. I mean, one thing is that during the press conference, he brought a helmet stating that I'm going to need the, you know, this was a medieval helmet, you know, the knights use them.
Right.
You know, he brought it along with him telling me that I'm going to need the helmet. And even if I do wear the helmet, he'll still knock me out.
Uh-huh.
That's what he was stating. And no matter what I do, he'll knock me out or something like that. And he always disrespected us, the way they looked at us, the way his manager and everybody looked at us, you know, they looked at us with inferiority. I mean, they just looked at us like we were nothing, you know, and I was really angry. I mean, even the day of the fight, that morning we had to weigh in again because it's the IBF rules. And they were just rude as ever. I mean, they were saying, you know, okay, it's time. Okay, get ready. And they actually invited my family saying that, oh, you know what, you guys can join us in after party after we win.
Oh, victory party.
Right, victory party.
Pala silang plano mag victory
party in the
si
morning. Exactly.
Okay. Imbitado naman si Junior Donaire. But so you know they say that if you're a boxer, you shouldn't mix your emotions. I mean, when you're inside the ring, you have to be very professional, very focused. But you're saying here that there was a lot of emotion involved.
Right.
I mean, you wanted to kill this guy.
I wanted to do everything right. I wanted to hurt him. I wanted to hurt him. I wanted to kill him if I had to. You know, he disrespected me, myself, my whole family, and all the people that believed in me, you know. And for me, the more that I was focused into beating him, the more that I was so calm, you know. A lot of people get crazy and they lose their focus. But for me, during that time, I mean, I think with God's help that I was really focused. And
well, Junior, but I mean, nagsasabi, no? Hindi ka lang skilled fighter. And you're not just a fighter with speed and power, but you have smarts.
I think that's my...
How did that evolve? You know, the fact that you're a thinking fighter. Did you get that from anyone? Or is it something that you just picked up along the way?
My father made it that way. I mean, he's always told us to have common sense. Common sense, use your brain. You know, be able to adapt to a lot of things in life. I mean, that's how he adapted into growing up and stuff like that. And he taught us the life... you know, about using our head all the time and thinking for yourself. And, you know, he's the one that started me into boxing. He taught me everything that I know.
Well, just explain very briefly how you broke down Darchinyan using your mind. What exactly did you see in Darchinyan, a weakness that you spotted and that you exploited and that you just broke him down little by little until he gave up?
A month before the fight, my dad and I made a strategy, you know, a game plan, basically. And one thing is that we looked at his style, and he did the same thing over and over, which was lunging, the jab would be just a fake, and he would throw with the left with all his might, and we knew that. And everything, there's times that every time he makes a move, I know what he was going to do. You know, every time he makes a step, he was going to throw a right, or a left, actually. Every time that he throws a power punch, he did the same thing, and I could tell everything that he was going to do and what he was going to do.
So you anticipated everything. You were always a step ahead.
A step
ahead. And then, of course, you knocked him out with one punch, and that's the end of Vic Darchinyan.